So, very quick test. So, make there my test. Test one. CD my test one. So, inside this directory, I'm going to create a script. Nano my test one shell script. And in that shell script, I'm just going to do really some really simple, stupid user bin and then bash and then just echo ID. So, and then you have that. So now I'm going to make the script executable, tmod plus x my test one shell, and well, I'll be f damned. Sorry for my cussing because I'm pissed off at that Justin TV piece of shit service. And I would just, oh, and then the EOF, I need to actually comment that. And now it just basically echoes the identity of me. So that's enough. So that's a script. And we're going to confine that script in using a raw policy really quick. So nano and then my test one and then type enforcement file and then it's module my test. This is the raw policy version, so it's not the I'll just use this. It's not the readable policy version. So this is the way you should probably start. So this is the raw policy module declaration, basically module and then the module name and the version. And then we're going to require some types because when you run a script, you have a source process running a executable file, and then that executable file is an entry point to the new process that is spawned. So since I am currently in the unconfined T domain and I'm going to run the script, I'm going to have to import the unconfined T domain and role and type identifiers, because those are not going to be declared. Those identifiers are declared in another module, so we need to import them. Just like if you import, for example, some function from some Python library, you need to first import that library or that function before you can actually use it. So, and the same goes for unconfined T. Type unconfined T, and then role unconfined R. So these are things that we borrow from another policy module, and so we need to import them first, and that's what we are doing here. Now we're going to just create a couple types. So type, and I'll call this my test one underscore T. This is the process type that I talked to you about on the IRC channel, and then the my test one underscore exec T is the executable file type. We're going to label that my test one shell script with that type. So now let's make that my test underscore t type a domain type. So now I'm not going to explain how you can figure out which attribute you can use and all that stuff. I'm just going to keep it really simple. So we need to con we're going to require some attributes because those aren't actually re imported or declared in this module either. So attribute and then domain first. Domain, and we'll also need exec type, and we need file type. So these are like three attributes that are externally declared that we want to use. So how to let's just assign the domain attribute type attribute to the mytest domain underscore t type. So type attribute, and it's one, well, it's like this. Type attribute my test one t, and then it's domain. So this should assign the domain type attribute to the to that type. Let's just do the others as well. Type attribute my test one exec t, and then assign the exec type first the file type, because first and foremost this is a file, this is the type of a file. And then I'll just exact type. And so that those are the first, I guess. So now the types are basically made usable. We just said, okay, this type is a process type, and this type is a file type, and it's also an executable file type. So it's not just a file type, but it's an executable file type. So now we have set that up, and now basically we need to start really simple, make a type transition. So just tell as Linux that type transition, and then tell us Linux that if the unconfined process type runs a file with the my test one executable file type exec underscore t type, then the domain transition process transition from unconfined t to my test one t. Now basically that's almost it, but we need to also take care of role-based access control. So we need to, and we already did include the unconfined R role. So now we need to basically allow the unconfined R role access to the new type. So unconfined R types my test one T. And now basically this should be it. Now let's just also make this type a permissive type. Permissive, and then my test one T is a, that's a process type, and that's what's made permissive. So let's just see where this gets us. Make F user, and let's just use the check module. So like you should basically mount check module, and then here it has how you an example of how you can do that. So copy that and paste it, and it's changed this my test one, and here we have already an error, a syntax error. So let's fix that. So I guess the comma is not needed here. I'm not sure, but it seems. Oh, and there's other errors as well, then I think. Yeah, there's also, we need to also require some stuff here more. For example, we need to require the process class process, and I'll just use the transition because this is raw policy, so you need to explicitly require stuff. So let's try that again, and now it compiled. Now we need to use man se module package to package this up. Package, and here you have an example of how to package it. Build a, yeah, no file context, so this one here, and then paste that in, and then we'll just call this my test one and it's created. So let's see. As I'll see, and there's a policy package here. This is what we need to install. So se module, sudo se module install, and then my test one pp. So now basically we're installing this module. Hopefully it installs. And that basically what we need to do is actually assign that executable file type to the script. So that's tcon t, and then the type my test one exec t, the type of the executable file. And now let's just run it. My test one shell, see if this runs. So the process is now a permissive process. My test t underscore t is permissive, but it might not work, but it probably will work. Oh, it doesn't work. So as you can see, there's already as Linux is already barking, and you would say, okay, but why is that? Because our type is now permissive, so it should work. Well, let's have a look. Assert m avc t TS recent, and that's sudo, of course. And here we have it. What's happening here is that unconfined is not allowed, unconfined T is not allowed to transition to the my test underscore T. So as Linux knows that when unconfined T runs the my test underscore exec underscore T file, that it should process transition from unconfined T to my test one underscore T. But it's just not allowed, and not because my test underscore T is not allowed it, but because unconfined T is not allowed it. So we need to actually allow that. So we can basically out it to allow, and then R, and then basically put that into our my test one TE file. And now cut my test one TE. And now you can see that it actually added the rules required to make this happen to the file. So let's just rebuild it. So use the God damn it. Use the check module. Where is the check module? And then package it up again. And then install it again. And this is basically all you need to do, kind of. Probably. There's not probably not much more. And then you can basically start troubleshooting. So now you have the bare minimums set up for confining this stuff, and now you can basically just do it again. My test one shell, I'll be damned, ls my test one shell, and now it works, and you can see that it actually domain transitioned, because I'm no longer unconfined T, I'm now my the script, the process type is now my test one underscore T. So it happened, but there's of course AVC denials, but it's allowed. So just basically let's just add it to allow it, and it's not shouldn't be so many AVC denials. So this is actually what this script does. So now you can basically add those rules in there, and that'll make the stuff work. So basically so that's how you troubleshoot. So now it is allowed, it is permissive. Only the my test underscore T type is permissive. But and it will, if you run it, it will show you what it needs to be able to run. And you basically you do should do a few test runs for that. So like let's say TS1456, let's see. So yeah, so now basically I could put that into my test one TE, and now it should be there. Get it? See, now the rules are actually added, but it's adding raw policy, and that's not a good idea. So that's wrong. Damn. Nano. Remove this stuff here. I did it wrong. This mon is added to allow. It's probably a lower R. Yeah, it's a lower R instead of an upper R. And now it's adding the raw rules. So now I can basically simply no make it again. Package it again, and then install it again until all the AVC denials are gone. And it's now 1500, so 3 o'clock in the PM. So run, hurry. Okay, and now just basically run it again. My test one shell. And see if there's any AVC denials from 1500. 1500. Always do a couple of tests. No, don't. Okay, so no more AVC denials. So let's just change this to enforcing mode. So just comment out the permissive statement, and now it's, when I'm building it, it's going to be in enforcing mode if it works. But it might actually be pop up some issues here. Where it stops working, because that's some bug in how S-Linux works, that when you try it in permissive mode, then everything seems to be fine, no more AVC denials, and then all of a sudden you try it in enforcing mode, and then that new AVC denials pop up. So now we're in enforcing mode, full stop. So my test one shell, and it's permission denied. See, stupid is that? That's really stupid, I think. So let's just see what it's got. See, it can't search. It's this. So let's just out of to allow R, and then my test one TE. It's just so unbelievable of stupid. And I get it again. See that it added it. Nano. So see, it adds it. This is basically to traverse. It needs to basically get traverse to the current PWD. And does probably use home directory. Oh, that's already allowed. Okay, now build this again. Package it again. Install it again. And hopefully now it will actually work. And that's basically how you develop a policy. But you really need to try to understand some of these permissions and rules. The type transition rule is important, and permissions like transition and entry point. So here's the entry point, and the transition permissions are important. So we're in enforcing mode. Let's see if it works now. And now it works. Let's see if we have any AFC denials at 1502. So now we're done. Now the policy is basically done. So I'll just uninstall this. Sudo sh module re-r my test one, remove it, and then rm this dir. Jesus Christ, this takes a long time. Cd rm rf my test one. Okay, that's it. I'll upload this.